The Gage Mansion is a Queen Anne-style house. According to our local expert, Nancy Shedd, these style of houses had irregular plans, and the placement of such things as towers and porches was somewhat random. Originally, there was a log cabin on this site. This house was built by Colonel George F. Gage, who bought the property in 1896. It has Italian marble floors and stained glass, which means the Colonel was definitely flashing the cash, because bringing marble from Italy during that time period was no easy feat. What really was his best status symbol or bragging right was the fact that he owned a telephone. Gio was brought here by the Huntington and Broadtop Mountain Railroad. He served as the railroad's general manager. The management team Gage was part of was described as most thorough and energetic. It is said that he saved the company from bankruptcy and made it one of the most successful local railroads in the region. In 1852, the railroad was approved to be built. It provided both passenger rail service and linked various coal towns throughout Huntington County. The freight division carried pig metal, iron ore, and coal. Excitement reached its peak in 1855 when a steam engine named Beaver traveled 8 miles along the tracks. Those interested can visit the Broadtop Area Coal Miners Museum located in Robertsdale. Now, the Gage family came to Huntington from New York State and were originally from Vermont. They don't seem to have stayed in the area longer than 3 generations, and even those generations are shrouded in mystery. One descendant was Frank, who married and had one son. The son passed away for unknown reasons at an unknown age. Perhaps as a response to this, Frank's wife threw herself into a local creek and committed suicide. And that's not even where the ghost stories come from. For that, we turn to the mansion's owner, Annie Wishard.
Well, the house was built more than 114 years ago, and when I came to look at it, the first time I came to look at it, I was totally enchanted. And I stood in the stairway that's behind you here, and I said, oh, all I can see is a bride waiting to come down the steps. And the realtor, who was very tall, bent down and said, then you've heard. And I said, no. And he said, the house is haunted. He said, the woman who lived here, the daughter, went crazy, died of a broken heart, is how he said it. And I went, oh, yeah, I don't know if I'm going to live here. But I was so attached. It, within an hour, I was so in love with the place, I did live here. And I do live here. And what happened is this husband and wife had a daughter named Helen. Helen went through high school here in Huntington, and then she graduated, and they sent her off to Europe with friends as a special trip for graduating. And what happened is she was going to marry a young man she went to school with, and she was so in love and so excited, but when she came home, her father had paid him off and sent him away because he wasn't good enough. The woman then, she lived to be 60 in the house with her mother, who lived to be in her 90s. She never left the house, and when she did, it was not appropriate to leave the house. She was just out of her head and depressed. And then, you know, a woman got married, and that was her whole life. Since I've been here, you hear dancing in the ballroom, music in the ballroom. My jewelry has disappeared. I had the piece disappear again recently. Doors will open. There, it's not bad stuff, though. I mean, it's just to let you know we're here, and it's okay, you're here. And when they get to be too pushy, I will say, in the stairway, I'll say, if you scare me, I'm moving. So we've had ghost hunters here, and they've found all kinds of things. They've heard voices, and, you know, it is definitely a haunted house. People come up and tell me stories. I see faces. Bed and breakfast guests will come through and walk down the street to Boxers for dinner or something, or over to Mimi's, and they'll say, who's on the third floor? And I'll say, no one. And they won't go upstairs to bed till I take them up and tuck them in, because they saw lights and people moving around. And we've had all kinds of strange experiences, but it's not bad ghosts. It's, I mean, if you're going to meet a ghost, you may as well meet him here, because it's so much better. So this is something the whole town knows about, and people always call it the Haunted Mansion. And so I'm happy to be here with those other women and one man, I think. I'm not sure. And I hope you all come to Huntington to visit, because this is the place. And the house is quite beautiful. If you're going to meet ghosts, you may as well meet them here in Huntington. It's a beautiful town, historic, and our ghosts are really friendly, so please stop by.
If you want a chance to experience the house at its creepiest, come in October to experience Huntington. The color is the only thing that has changed about the house, so the ghosts must be content with Annie living here. I'm going to hand you back over to Sean now as we shift gears from ghosts to revolution. See you again at Stop 9.